In this video, we are going to see another example of AJAX. So here, let us say almost the program is similar to the one what we have seen earlier. So in the, this is in HTML, we have start with the HTML head, and here the JavaScript is done and the function name is loaddocs. What it is doing, initially we declared a variable called u, and then we check for whether this is an when we create the XML HTTP request, whether it is for meant for the browser in which it's running is a Internet Explorer or other than that IE. If it is other than IE, then this coding will be executed. That is, new XML HTTP request is object is an instance of this object is created, and the name of that instance is u. Else it creates an ActiveX object, because IE needs an ActiveX object. So this will be created. Then we check for the onReady state change. Here we use the callback function. So here this is a callback function where when here u.open get input.php true, because this is the URL. This is the program name which we are sending it in the URL. If this is that, then send. If it is true, then once it is executed and if this method is executed, the data will be whatever is in the browser side, that will be client side, that will be sent to the server, and the, in the server side, the script process the data and it will be sent. And then once it is received, then here it will check. That is what done by this callback function. Once it is sent, it will call back the values from the server. And here it checks whether ready state equal 4. 4 means successful. The new dot state, this is again, it is successful. So we check whether this value, if is it equal to this value. In that case, then we display it in the element tag which has this ID. So what ID where we are having is, we have displayed, we have created the div ID equal to C. So this div element has this ID. So there we display the value which we are getting it from the PHP, from the server side. So that is placed on u.response text. And then that will be placed on the inner HTML of this div element. So this is how it works. Now if you see that, this is the content of the PHP file. Here what we do is we just echo. Okay, so this data will be cached and it will be displayed in the div element, the C element. So now when you execute this coding, you will be having this output. Initially, when you execute, it will be like this. And then when you press the submit button, you will have the output like this. So here it will be displayed. You don't see any flicking, nothing. So for example, I run it again, reload. So here, you see that? See, there is no flicking. Only this portion is loaded, not this and this portion is loaded.